Heads up below. Box coming down. Hop in. We'll bring you up. Well, all right, McNamara. Good job. Wait a minute. You're not McNamara. Who the... Rangers? Rangers? Woohoo! Rangers! Our saviors! Well, I guess I gotta thank you for taking care of these clowns. Though you could have got here before they wrecked our irrigation system and killed our mayor. You gonna go finish them off now? Or are you just here for our radio tower like you told Mayor Vikstrom? Not all of them. And the rest of them will be back for a reckoning. That'll be the end of us. Unless you or the Red Scorpions take them out first. Personally, I'm inclined to ask the Scorpions to do it. They get things done. But if you want to try doing your job for a change, well, they must have a camp around here somewhere. Find it and start shooting. That is, after all, what you do best. Those wreckers couldn't hit what they were aiming at if their lives depended on it. But they got in a lucky shot yesterday and shot Mayor Vikstrom when they was aiming at me. Blew him clear off the wall. I've had to step in as temporary commander now Vikstrom's gone. But I aim to hold a vote and make it official as soon as things calm down. Then we'll have some real law and order around here. And we won't have to rely on the Rangers for help anymore either. You still think the Rangers are the only ones who can deliver justice in this world? Ha! You got another think coming. Gonna have a show of hands in the town square once we get these wreckers dealt with and the irrigation fixed. Kate Preston thinks she's a shoo-in, but I'm the one getting things done around here. All she does is talk. I think the people will make the right choice. I don't know. Maybe nothing. Kate Preston says a wrecking crew bomb smashed some valves and it's leaking like a sieve. She's been down in the tunnels trying to fix it since the attack started. I think she's just hiding from the fighting like the woman she is. She thinks she's got the answer to everything. She thinks she's smarter than everybody else. Well, she's got the same problem the Rangers do. Whole lot of talking and not so much doing. Call themselves the Wrecking Crew. Stupid name. But then they all have stupid names. Like that jackhammer chick. Of course, if the shoe fits. I've seen a lot of freaks come out of the waste in my time, but I've never seen anything like her before. She had an arm like a jackhammer. How is that possible? Doc Warner couldn't do a surgery like that in a million years. Our local sawbones. Me and the doc don't see eye to eye on a lot of things, but I owe him for a life saved, so I leave him be. Never mind about that, Rangers. It's not your business. I'm surprised you haven't heard of them, you being the law around here. They've been around for a year or so. Only mobile junkyard I've ever seen. Don't know why they got all aggressive all of a sudden. They've upgraded their weapons, too. Who has a jackhammer arm? How is that shit possible? Anyhow, they fucked us up proper. Not only did they kill the mayor and burn down our spring crop, but apparently one of their bombs smashed our irrigation system, too. Gonna take a while to get back to normal. After your history with us, you're damn right we got a problem with you. You're tolerated here, but you won't never be loved. I guess old Snake ain't too keen to teach his new recruits the truth about the Rangers' glorious past. Well, let me fill you in. 15 years ago, you fuckers came out here and shot a little orphan boy's dog. Then you shot the little orphan boy, my nephew Bobby, who weren't armed with nothing but a BB gun. A BB gun! Well, after that, High Pool only accepted ranger protection because there was nobody else to turn to. Now there is. So you can go tell the general we ain't forgotten and we ain't forgiven. And if he isn't careful, we ain't sending him any water no more either. Well, are we? You'd think the rangers would keep a better eye on the place that provides them with the most of their water. The rangers don't want to protect us anymore. The scorpions are thirsty too. Keep it in mind. Bobby's where the rangers can't hurt him anymore. I visit his grave every day. Rex's too. The dog and his boy, together forever. He's buried right over there, right next to Bobby. Huh? Nobody. You wouldn't know him. Okay. No need to get rough. He's just a guy who, you know, you rangers aren't the only game in town. We haven't seen you for nigh on a year, and the Red Scorpions show up when we call them. At least most times they do. Captain McNamara and the rest of the RSM have done right by us more times than you have. That's for damn sure. Hey, they're closer than you. They don't try to solve problems by shooting little children. Sure, we gotta pay them, but at least they work for their money. You say that, but I know the truth. You just stay away from our kids, Rangers. They're all we got in this shitty world. I won't warn you twice. Huh. I thought as much. Rangers always think of themselves first. But we got an antenna up on the crane. But if you want to use it, you'll have to get it back online. There's some kind of short in the tunnels beneath the reservoir. See Kate Preston down there. She'll give you directions if she isn't too busy fixing leaks.
Go on, then. Remind us why we agreed to
nice
your
to
protection.
Nice to see you too, Bergen.
Heads up below! Fuck! We'll bring you up.
Well, you're gonna go finish them off now?
I've had to step in it. You still think the rain gonna have a show of hands? I don't know. Maybe nothing. She thinks she's got the answer to everything. She thinks she's smarter than ever. Call themselves the Wreck. I've seen a lot of freaks come out of the waste in our local Sawbones. Me, never mind about that rape. Anyhow, they fucked us up after your history. Well, after that, well, are we? Bobby's where the Rangers can't hurt him. He's buried right over there. Huh? Nobody. You wouldn't know him. You know, you Rangers aren't. Hey, they're closer than you say that. Huh. I thought as much.
Go on, then. Remind us why we agreed
to
your protection.
Nice to see you too, Logan.
Thank you.
Who's in that cell? Doesn't look like a wrecker to me. Thank you, Desert Rangers. I have heard that your tribe brings justice to the Wastes. Then bring justice here and free me from this cage. I would travel with you if you would have me. There is much I can help you with, and you can help me as well. I am not from these lands. My tribe lives beyond the radiation wall, to the south. 2 moons ago, the winds shifted, and the wall became a path to this land. I and some braves of my tribe were chosen to travel here, to trade and learn. But the Great Spirit did not smile on our journey. Savages attacked us and only I survived. When I turned my feet toward home, the winds had changed again, and the path was gone. The way back to my family, my tribe, my children, gone. When the path did not return in the passing of a moon, I decided that the Great Spirit must mean for me to learn as much as I could of these lands, so that I might someday return to my people with new wisdom. So I set out, but sadly, the first place I came to was here. A town of little wisdom. Still, I am hopeful. Thus, I ask to travel with you and learn what I can. In return, I can trap, tame the beasts of the wild, heal you, help you find water, and fight at your side. May I walk your path? You honor me. As soon as you free me, I am ready. I was arrested here. The owner betrayed me. Thank you.
Copy, Echo One. This is Ranger Command. Go ahead. Echo One, your recent progress merits a field promotion for one of your team. Congratulations, Echo One. You've done well.
Let's get out of here. Too many bad memories. Hopeless. I can't fix it in time. We're ruined. Who's there? Wreckers, please don't kill. Oh, Rangers. You're here. Finally, some good news. I knew you'd show up. I knew Bergen was wrong about you. And you must have chased off those wreckers or you wouldn't be down here. Well, that's Crisis 1 solved anyway. Only Crisis 2 and Crisis 3 to go. Crisis 3 is right here and right now. I should be up top at the moment, trying to convince everybody to make me the new mayor, but our irrigation system is about to blow sky high. Loading's gotta wait. Otherwise, High Pool is going straight down the drain. Those damn wreckers lobbed a bomb over the wall that shook up our irrigation system and busted the pressure regulator. It also shorted out half of our electrical system, and we've only got enough juice to keep a few lights on at a time. Killed the radio, too. I'm using the backup system to let off some of the pressure, but it's building too fast. If something isn't done very soon, we'll lose all our water and all our topsoil in one big bang. Are you here to help? First, I need you to head into the complex. Look for 4 release valves and open them so the water can flow. Then all you have to do is come back here and open the bypass valve over there on the other side of the room. That will stabilize the pressure in the system and return things to normal. Got it? Good. When the water drains from the reservoir, it's going to flood our fields and take all our topsoil with it. Those wreckers already burned our current crops to the ground. If we lose the soil too, we won't be able to grow our own food for years. If the system blows, all the water will drain out of our reservoir at once. We'll be dry for months. The whole region will go thirsty. All right. Mayor Vikstrom said you were coming to use the tower for some kind of experiment. He's not here anymore, but I suppose it's okay. However, the breaker flipped during a short and cut off power to the radio. Thank God I was smart enough to place that on a different generator than our lights. So it'll have enough juice for you, but someone needs to reset the breaker and flip the power back onto the radio. Pretty low priority on my list right now, but it's located in Section 6 in the middle of the complex. Poor Mayor Vikstrom got killed on the walls yesterday. And now we gotta vote for a new mayor. I don't really want to replace Vikstrom, but if I don't stand, nobody else will, and Sean Bergen will get the job. That would be a disaster. Well, as soon as things settle down, we'll have a show of hands in the town square. If you can help me solve all these crises, I think I've got a good chance of winning, and you'll have a pro-Ranger mayor here. If Bergen gets voted in, well, High Pool will be even less friendly to the Citadel than it already is. Crisis number 2 is the rest of the wrecking crew. They're like weeds. If you don't tear them out by the roots, they'll come back stronger than ever. I've been asking Ranger Citadel for months to find their camp and get rid of them, and nothing ever gets done. If you want us to keep sending you water, you gotta get these guys off our back. Permanently. But that'll have to wait until Crisis 3 is sorted out. No more time for questions. We'll talk once we fix the system. Go find those valves!
I die a little whenever I cannot see the sky.
Keep your eyes open down here. Could be anything running around in the dark.
Ranger Citadel, this is Kathy Lawson at Ag Center again. Where the fuck are you bastards? We're dying here.
Kathy, this is General Vargas. Keep cool and listen. The only team I have near you is already answering an emergency call at Highpool, but I put out a general call for assistance in your area. Now, hopefully some citizen...
Are you fucking kidding me? You picked those rain collectors over us? Have fun starving to death, assholes. Don't you understand what we're going through here? We've fallen back to the lobby, but we've got fruit flies as big as bulldogs dive-bombing us everywhere we go. And Matt Forrestal took some kind of exploding seed pod full in the face. He's a goddamn wreck.
Kathy, please, just hold on. We're doing the best.
Fuck you, Vargas. We don't need your goddamn sweet talk. We need help.
Thank you. low, so I'm guessing you got a valve open. Great work. There's only three more in the complex, so you're 25% of the way there already.
But the water is really... Oh, crap! Pressure's just hit critical. I'll keep doing what I can from here, but you've got to take care of those valves.
Kathy, I'm reading you loud and clear.
Please, Vargas, I'm sorry I shouted at you. Please, send somebody. Matt is dying, and there's no more ammo, and I...
Hey, it's got nothing to do with you shouting, Kathy. There's just nobody to send. My crew are dealing with the crisis in Highpool as quick as they can. If you can just hold on a little while longer.
Shit! They're coming in again!
Kathy? Kathy, are you there? Ranger Citadel calling Ag Center. Do you read me? Ag Center, come in!
Some more blue lights just went on up here, Rangers. Thanks. Two down, two to go.
Ranger Citadel. This is Kathy Lawson. center. Don't come. There's no one left. Answer.
Oscillating wildly in section 10. The only other time I've seen something like this, the valve was completely rusted through. If that's what's going on, you'll have to find a replacement to install. If you haven't got one already, you might want to check the storage area near section 2. have the honors. You earned it, that's for sure.
Is flowing smoothly and the pressure is relieved. For the first time in a while, nothing is about to explode. Now that the crisis has passed, I'm guessing the town's gonna want to vote for a new mayor right away. I'd better head up. Thanks again, Rangers.
Okay, let's hold the vote. All those who want Sean Bergen to be mayor, say aye. Right. Now all those who want Kate Preston to be mayor, say aye. That was split pretty even. I don't know what to do now.
Well, how about we recess for a while and try the vote again a little later? Give the people some time to consider their choices. What do you say, Sean?
Yeah, I guess that's fine. Holler when we're ready to do this again.
Okay, great. Hey, Rangers, do you have a sec to talk? To help out around town, I'm pretty sure I can convince people to vote for me. On the other hand, if you guys would live down to your local reputation, which is not pretty, then Bergen would probably win. I'm not going to call for another vote until I think we can win, but Bergen's going to call foul if I wait too long. So get back to me ASAP once you think people's minds are swaying to our side. Sound good? I'm glad to hear it. I knew I could count on you.
Copy, Echo One. This is Ranger Command. Go ahead. Over. Echo One, I'm happy to say several members of your team have earned field promotions. Congratulations, Echo One. You've done well.
Breaking a criminal out of jail, Rangers? That's pretty low. Even that vulture's cry, or whatever she calls herself. You got some balls breaking her out of our jail and walking around with her in broad daylight. Unless you got a good explanation why she ain't in our jail awaiting her hanging, you're not welcome here. When it walks like a freak and talks like a freak and shows up a day before a raider attack, what do you expect us to do? We know a wrecking crew scout when we see one.
Yeah, well, don't let the door hit you in the ass on the way out.
You freed our prisoner? What the hell?
Roger, Echo One. We just received the high pull relay signal. Looks like everything's hooked up correctly. We should be...
The gift I want to pass on to you, the weak, the downtrodden, the persecuted and enslaved, come to the new Citadel, join our Brotherhood, and you too will wear the armor of the evolved. You too will be immortal, invulnerable, untouched by disease or age for all time. You will be a perfect being, ready to lead the world into a golden future of light, beauty, and...
God's mercy is in the bullets of our guns, brothers and sisters. It is in the tips of our bayonets. It is in the death of every sinner who is too blind to turn to the light. Every time we end a life in this godforsaken world, we end misery and bring peace. So I say unto you, friends, praise the Lord and...
Damn it, Woodson! I did not want that to go out over the air! Sorry about that, Echo One. Good job, you're halfway there. Please proceed to Ag Center ASAP. We're still getting SOS calls from that location. Again, deal with the emergency first. The radio tower second. Copy? Roger, Echo One. Ranger Command out. Copy, Echo One. This is Ranger Command. Go ahead. Over. Echo One, your team's recent progress merits a number of field promotions. Congratulations, Echo One. You've done well.
Thank you.
I must not think of vengeance. This place has seen enough death. They trap water, and also themselves. Let us leave this place. I long to be miles from here.
Fucking wreckers really mess things up around here.
Hey, Rangers. I don't think we've got the people on our side quite yet. I've got to keep track of things, so I'll have to talk to you later.
Massacre. What could have done this? What symbol is this on the wall?
Another fucking robot. What the hell?
You freed our prisoner? What the hell?
thank you for freeing me from that viper's nest. It is one thing to live in the desert. It is another to thrive in it. These people do neither.
Thank you.
Do they really think weighing themselves down with all that crap is helping?
Hey, Rangers. I don't think we've got the people on our side quite yet. I've got to keep track of things, so I'll have to talk to you later.
Wrecking crew wrecked. Irrigation system fixed. That's what I call doing the job right. Thank you, Rangers. We'll be calling the Citadel from now on.
Hey, Rangers. I don't think we've got the people on our side quite yet. I've got to keep track of things, so I'll have to talk to you later.
Wrecking crew wrecked, and irrigation system fixed. That's what I call doing the job right. Thank you, Rangers. We'll be calling the Citadel from now on.
The balance of nature should not have been trifled with. This sickness comes from the arrogance of people out of tune with the land. Nature has been perverted. The balance of nature should not have been trifled with. This sickness comes from the arrogance of people out of tune with the land. Nature has been perverted.
Watch it. Looks like the pod was triggered by a sudden movement.
You, Rain.
What the fuck was the point of showing up now? Ag Center is destroyed. The cure is lost. And I'm about to be eaten by a fucking tree. We found a cure, but too late. Way too late. Matt was too far gone by then. Everybody was. Rose tried to take a canister of the serum to the nutrient reservoir tanks in the east greenhouse so we could feed it to the plants and stop their growth, but she didn't make it. A bunch of the pod people blew her to pieces, and now the whole area is completely unreachable. Yep, that very same. You're industrious when you put your minds to it. I'll give you that. Matt built a great thing here. I know you Rangers think you're guardians of the future, but we were the ones that were gonna keep everybody from starving.
Now it's ruined. It's going to be a hungry future. Not fast enough, jerks. God damn it, I thought Ag Center and Ranger Citadel had a deal. Wasn't it? We give you food, you give us protection. Well, you're looking pretty goddamn well fed. But we got our asses handed to us by killer tomatoes for 8 hours and not a ranger in sight. And killer pumpkins and killer fruit flies. All of a sudden, all our plants started growing out of control, mutating, exploding, attacking my people. It's like they went rabid or something. Matt and Rose and I managed to get to safety, but the researchers and the farmers, I watched them die one by one on the monitors while you butterballs were off circle jerking each other. And for some of them, it was even worse. You haven't seen them yet? They're wandering all through this jungle. Those were our people, our friends. And now they're, I don't know what they are, pod people. I don't know how it works. Somehow the infection gets into their nervous systems, changes their physiology, and makes them lash out at any uncontaminated people around them. Rose was our best researcher and my mentor. Helped me come up with a cure that stopped the plant mutations from spreading. But she got killed before she could distribute it. What a waste. No, poor bastard got hit by shrapnel from one of those exploding pods. And now he's dead. Maybe if Dr. Larson hadn't disappeared, we could have saved him, but we're too late with the cure. He was a godsend, is what he was. Not only was he a fine general practitioner and surgeon, he was doing great work in the field of fungal biology. He'd really expanded our areas of research. Now he's gone. We didn't see him again after the madness started. I suppose he's dead somewhere like all the others. As if the rest of it wasn't enough, the plants also started to explode. Get too close to one of those red pods and bam, you're torn up by shrapnel. And worse, if you're not treated, the fungal spores start growing in your body until you turn into one of those pod people. Oh, none of you have been hit, I hope. Oh, I suppose that's a good thing. A little karma wouldn't have been so bad, though. Find that serum and you won't have to worry about it. We discovered that the plants were going insane because of some contamination in the fertilization system, rapidly mutating fungal spores. Rose thought it was deliberate sabotage, but I'm not sure. Whatever it is, all the vegetation started growing out of control and mutating. The insects, too, they're enormous. One of our researchers, a boy named Sue, fed some of our pigeons spore-infected seeds and sent them off. I saw him on the monitors, but couldn't stop him. If those pigeons shit those seeds in other places, the infection will spread. The trouble is, I have no idea where the pigeons went. You're just going to have to listen for trouble on your radios. If you find the serum, save some for any distress calls you get. We use them as backups when the radio isn't working. They carry messages for us to every community in the wastes. Only now, I'm afraid they are carrying death. An odd duck, that boy. And not just because of his name. We hired him on because of his passion and enthusiasm. But he was very young and a bit sloppy in his methods. I'm afraid it's killed him, and maybe more than him. I saw a fruit fly as big as a bald eagle. It had a stinger like a fucking scimitar. I hope not. I don't want to think that anyone here would do this. We're a happy family. We all want the same thing, to make the wasteland green again. Huh. Well, you might as well have stayed home. We've gone from distressed to deceased, thanks to you slow-poke assholes. Everybody's dead. Matt, Rose, all of them. And I'm next. No, stay back. The vines twitch if you hit them. Cut them and they'll crush me like an egg. Just leave me. Find the serum Rose and I made. Hag Center is lost. You might be able to save our outlying areas that got infected. And yourselves if you get blasted by an exploding pod. Go on. Go. Find the canister of serum. Kill these damn plants. God, it's contracting again. My ribs. I fuck you.
Copy, Echo One. This is Ranger Command. Go ahead. Over. Echo One, your team's recent progress merits a number of field promotions. Congratulations, Echo One. You've done well. Thank you. Echo, this is Ranger Citadel. Come in. Over. 10-4, Echo 1. It looks like that plague of plant growth might not have been confined to Ag Center after all. I got a call from Marjorie at Stubbins Farm, who said giant vegetables were taking over her fields. Head over there right away. We gotta nip this plague in the bud, so to speak. You copy? 10-4, Echo 1. Sending you the coordinates now. Ranger Citadel out.